Good morning, students. Again, I am with you and continue with the topic the fun with the magnet. Now here we are in previous class we have talked about the magnetic and non-magnetic materials. We have discussed about what is magnetic and what is non-magnetic materials, and also we have discussed how to find out the direction of any place. The answer is to by the use of the compass we can find out the direction of any place. Now some descriptions also I have given related to compass, all these things which we have covered in previous class. Now the another things which already we have discussed in that class, that is the how to make a own magnet. These things we have discussed in previous class. Now we are going to talk about the some of the conscious by which we can understand whether the magnetic or magnet things can be destroyed or not. These things which we have to understand, and what are the some precautions should be there, so that the kind of the things which we are using whether it is not going to harm to any kind of the harmful circumstances of in the environment. Now there is a first, let me choose the highlighter. And the first point is talk about the when heated, hampered or dropped from a height, magnet tends to lose their property. Why this happens? There is a property when the magnets are hampered or dropped dropped from a height, whether these magnets have lose their property or not. The magnets lose their property because of magnets is basically the kind of the object which is attracted by the things. Now the whenever the we heat it, what happened here, the force will be weakened, and because of the less force, what happened, the magnetic field will create very less, and because of this the magnetic property get lost. Now they become weak if they are not stored properly, and hence that's why it is written here, whenever these things are not kept at a proper stored at a properly at a proper place, these properties are lost. Now bar magnet, when we talk about the bar magnet should be stored in a pair separate by a small block of woods. It is also, since it is a kind of the energy which is kind of the attraction between the two things, and when these attraction are continuously take place a particular place, what happen, these kind of materials will lose their property. And they are unlike coal, facing the same side with soft iron across their end. That means whenever we have unlike poles, that should be covered with a soft iron, same side with a soft iron across the end, there should be a some kind of the things which we have to put on a same side of the materials. A piece of iron should be kept across the pole in case of if there is a, as we know that there are the different kind of magnets, and one of these magnets are known as horseshoe magnet, and if these horseshoe magnets are that kind of the magnet should be kept across the pole. These should be kept across the pole. The magnet should be kept away from the computer, mobile, television. Why this happened here? Because since in the television, computer, mobiles, they are also are electronic device, and these electronic device basically made up of nickel, cobalt and iron kind of the materials, and whenever they are kept nearby the magnet will attract and create a magnetic field, and because of this magnetic field there may be some cause of the cause of some kind of the reflection, or we call as a radiations. So we should protect from these things with nearby the computer, mobile and television. Loss of magnetic properties. Now this is the things which we you have to remember. The magnetic property of a magnet is lost on these are the things when we heat it, when we hamper it, and when it's dropping it. There is a heat is very, it should be very clear, whenever you heat the materials will melt, and when the materials will melt it forms a very weak force, and because of that weak force the property will lost. And when we hampered it or heating it, what happens against the same thing will happen while hampering the magnets gets loose in their the two atoms. When they lose their the in between, if there is a the atoms of the magnets are very far away from each one, and then what happened, the magnetic field will not created as much previously, and because of that it would be lost their property. Now here the another things is dropping. By dropping is also loss of the magnetic property, and what happened here when we drop the magnet from a top any kind of the top place, then the when they get on the fall down on the earth, what happens, it may be the poles which collide on the particular place, it happens there may be some kind of the breakage can be also done. If that things not happened by dropping, then it may be some the hit by the particles, and at that time the force of attraction will also loosed, and because of this there may be some loss of the property of magnet. So it is very important things which you have to understand, which is the condition in which the magnet lost their property. These are the some condition. Now the this is very important question. Do opposite really attract? Yes, the opposite poles really attract. Here you can see there are the two poles, north and south poles, and I have seen shown you different condition by which you can understand whether the attraction will take place or not. Here the north pole kept nearby the south pole, what happened, these are the two different poles. When these two different poles are, we can call as a two opposite poles, when these two different or opposite poles were kept at a particular place, there will be some magnetic lines also created. Due to that magnetic lines and the force of attraction created, and because of that these two are attract to one another. And when there are the on the same poles, like here north and north pole, then these two magnets are repelled to one another. Whereas there is a south pole, this happened also here, since it is the same pole, and because of this same poles they repel to one another. So like poles, this is the unlike poles, we call as a, if there are the two different poles, then it is called a unlike poles. and unlike poles attract to one another, whereas like poles, when there is on the two poles, same poles, then it is a like pole, and like poles are basically attract to, repel to one another. And there is another things which you have to also understand here, very very important things. When these magnets are separate, wants to separate, like here you can see here there is a north pole and south pole, and we by any process, if these two poles are separated, then again the in the separated part also becomes the north and south pole. And like from if we separate this magnet from this place, what happened here, the north pole is already here and the south pole all created, and in case of this the south pole is already present, so here the north pole will created. With this we can understand inseparable poles means the magnets are inseparable at inseparable poles. So these are the some points which is very important to understand all these kind of the things. This point is basically what is the use of the magnet we are talking about, and where it the different application of these magnets you have to understand. That is the the computer, MRI machines, and these are the some applications which are used by the magnet. And second thing, you can also hard disk. There is a hard disk in computer which used, that is also a made up of a magnetic materials. There is a TV, sound speaker and radio, these are the made up of magnetic materials. You can go through all these things. Only main important things, the at home you are you use a magnet when you stick a paper on refrigerator in order to remember something, there is a also magnet is also there. These things are important which you have to remember. What is the uses and what is the different application of this magnet. Now these are the question answers. Here all the questions already given in front of you, also answer is also given written here. I don't think you will not able to understand all these things if you read the questions. If you have a proper understanding about the topic, then you will be able to understand all these questions. Here the one questions I would like to read here so that you can make more sure, so to understand what you have to do. Here the question is in the form of filling in the blanks, and in that question the artificial magnet are different shape as such as. These artificial magnets are basically bar magnets, horse magnet, and cylindrical magnets, which is in our lecture. The materials which are attracted towards the magnets are called the magnetic material. Very good answer. The paper is not a material. Not a material. Paper is not a material, and the answer is hence it is a not a non-magnetic material. You can write here. In olden days, the sailor used to find the direction by suspending a piece of magnet. You can also note down these things. Also talk magnet always has a pole of north and south. These things also we have discussed. So like this, there are the different kind of the questions are given. Also the answer is also mentioned, all these questions. So go through all these question and answer, you will get all the kind of the solution of your questions. You can see all these things. whether it is a long question or short questions, all the questions are given here. This is one kind of the questions. These questions are basically based on magnetic material get attracted towards a magnets. There are the five serial number, and from first column to another column you have to match, and non-magnetic material do not. Non-magnetic materials do not get attracted towards a magnet. These are the here the question of 10 is here given, and the answer is written here. So it is all about this fun with magnet. Again, I want to conclude all these taught topics. First, you have to understand what is a magnet and what is the different property of magnet. Second thing which you have to understand, types of magnets, what is artificial magnet. There is a one questions may be asked like the history of the magnet. And another things which you have to understand, how the directions are found, some basic things about the compass, some and how it is made up, and how many types of poles, and north and south poles, what is the use of that the compass, and also various application of magnet, as well as the uses of magnet. Also we have to understand the whether the two poles are repelled to one another or attract to one another, another things which we have discussed about how to make your magnet. These things also you important things to understand, and the what are the different conscious for the if do not want to lose their magnetic property. These are the some important and basic point which you have to understand through these presentation. So it is all about that this topic, and today I have finished the one with the magnet. So we will meet next class with the next chapter, and that is the current electricity. We will talk about all these concepts. Thank you for today.